to live right, you must know right. You must have a foundation under your life if you're going to daily live out those things that really bring peace and hope and love and grace, mercy, that display the purpose for which God created you. You need to know right. Well, that's what the book of Romans is about. It's about the righteousness of God. Matter of fact, the theme of the book of Romans is the righteousness of God. The word righteous is used in one form or another over 40 times in these 16 chapters. In chapters 1 through 3, the Apostle Paul presents the need for righteousness. In chapters 3 through 8, God's provision for righteousness that's found only in Christ. In chapters 9 through 11, how Israel rejected God's righteousness. And then in 12 through 16, how righteousness must be lived in our daily practice, in our daily lives. The righteousness of God. The key verse, if you're studying this book with me, is found in Romans chapter 1, verses 16 and 17. Paul said, "For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone who believes, to the Jew first and also to the Greek. For in it, the righteousness of God is revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, the righteous shall live by faith." Now, the Bible teaches that all Scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine. It's profitable for basic teaching, laying a foundation under our lives. But definitely there are some parts of the Bible for you and me today that literally have more practical implications maybe than other parts. For instance, the book of Exodus is a great narrative of the redemption of Christ, but for us, and there are some great lessons in daily living there, but the book of Romans is a book that really gets right to where we are with the basic foundations of who Jesus is, what he did for us on the cross, and how the righteousness of God can be imputed to us. And so you find as the book of Romans has been used over the centuries, God has spoken to the hearts of some of the greatest Christian leaders that there ever were from the book of Romans. Matter of fact, St. Augustine was converted through reading the book of Romans. Martin Luther launched the Reformation on Romans 1:17, "The just shall live by faith." John Wesley, the founder of the Methodist Church, was converted while listening to someone reading from Luther's commentary on the book of Romans. And if there's any book in the New Testament that believers today and anyone should really begin to comprehend, meditate upon, and understand, the foundational book of our faith, the book of Romans. It's also interesting that the book of Romans is the first of the epistles of the New Testament. You have the Gospels, the life of Christ, his death, his burial, his resurrection, the book of Acts, the spread of the gospel throughout the world, and how God wants this great good news to go to every creature on planet Earth, the book of Acts. But then the very next book is the book of Romans, the book of Romans. And it's interesting that the next several books follow the pattern that all Scripture is given by inspiration of God's profitable for doctrine. Well, that's Romans, the great doctrinal book. It's given for reproof. That's 1 Corinthians and 2 Corinthians, where Paul reproves sin. It's given for correction. That's Galatians, where Paul corrects false teaching that's going on in the church. And then it's given for instruction in righteousness, Ephesians and other remaining letters of the Apostle Paul that teaches holy living based on Christian doctrine. So, my friend, we are going to have a great time as we look at this book of Romans. Remember the theme, the righteousness of God, how to have God's righteousness in an ungodly, unrighteous world, how to know that we are right with God. We have a right standing with God, the most important thing in all the world. What we find that taught in the book of Romans. I'm looking forward to it. I hope you'll be looking at it, reading, studying it with me, and prepare our hearts for God to speak to us in a wonderful and blessed way. God bless and have a wonderful and great day.